Some boy like Kanye.
You guys need to understand I'm multilingual.
I'm assuming English is one of the languages that
is communication.
There's something you didn't do. How can you forget? How can you forget? First story. A lot went down on Twitter. Guys, they are saying fake Nketsi's whole feline management modeling agency thing is fake.
Don't sue us.
Apparently, yeah. It's a front. Apparently, it's a front to pimp girls out to rich men.
You know what's unfortunate?
And what?
She's so fly for this, bro.
Bruh.
She's so pretty.
But you know, I since she's been popular and I've been.
Guys, Faith is pretty. I don't know why
you're Faith, I'll still be faithful to you. Just putting it out.
Guys, can we talk about what's actually happening? So this whole thing started off. This whole thing started off by this girl tweeting that she signed up to work with Faith, and what happened was she got sent out to work, and then she got raped by six men.
Who leaves the thing?
The girl. Someone. There's this. Well, I don't want to mention names, but there's this popular Twitter page that always leaks these stories.
In case you don't know what that means.
Alleged.
This is for legal purposes in case we
don't sue us, we are broke, we still here.
This girl said Faith paid her 20k to keep quiet about how Faith sent her to get raped.
So she took the 20k and still spilled the beans.
Come on. Why'd you take the money, huh?
No, yes, she was desperate. She needed the money. She was like, good evening, sir. She was DMing the person that's responsible for
the leakers.
Yeah, the leakers. I also want to testify because someone else said something small about Faith. So uh-huh. She was like, I also want
she
to
was
testify.
Confirming what was said.
Yeah, really. What was said already. I also want to testify.
Except she has 20k. That's the only two.
I also want to testify concerning the tweet I saw yesterday about Queen Turk. I was desperate and needed cash and joined Faith's agency for some quick cash. I ended up being raped by six men, all taking turns. And Faith paid me 20k to keep quiet. I took the money and said nothing or too ashamed. Sir, I'm telling you, that woman is a hardcore pimp. The whole modeling agency is just a front or maybe a side operation. Many girls are selling their bodies for this woman. Anyway, please keep my identity safe.
Once again, legal disclosure. This is alleged.
This is not alleged.
Has been confirmed.
But, don't sue us, Faith.
But you know, my take on this is, really, you look at these girls, Faith is not the only one. You ask yourself, you see these girls on Instagram, I've been for the longest time asking myself, where do you get the money
to
pimp your friends out, to buy bags for your friends, to fly out to Dubai whenever you feel like, to take your girls out, a whole squad of 10 girls, you go to the club.
It's one of two things, man. In most cases, it's either someone financing the whole process, commonly known as ESA. And then, secondly, there's some shady dealing happening because in most cases, it's not people that have, how can I put this, the intellectual capacity, sorry, not the legal, to start something lucrative and actually have businesses. And if they had, there's no transparency, it's just people living their lives, slaying, queening.
Accountant. Yeah, it's lucrative.
It's really.
But what I'm saying is, if she wasn't raped and all this sad stuff, then I say if you are doing whatever you're doing to get your money and you want to do it and you want to do that ish,
consent.
Do your girl.
Yes. You know how they always say, whenever you talk about someone or you talk about people, you have to say in the end, Guti, they doing their thing though.
Give him the Xbox.
Teach a man to fish. and you can.
Okay, so. I think another thing that's very interesting that happened recently, I know this guy, he stays around my hood, a couple of houses away. We don't have coffee. Bando Lomisa, I think he's
a president of
UGM, and he's also a general. He's also played a major, substantially major influence in the political space of, you know, Essex. So, I don't know, he had an interview, so he was saying this famous quote.
Everybody know that quote.
The irony of it all is that it's famous.
Everybody knows
but
it.
But still, he failed to deliver.
To say it.
We just watched the video.
He was trying to read the telephone.
As the adage says, you give a poor man a fish and you feed him for a day. You teach him to fish. You give him...
No. So he's telling the people at the back.
Look at that awkward stare, bro.
It's like he's telling the camera, like, save me. Switch off the cameras. Just cut.
Huh? How do you fail that part?
Yo, no.
How do you fail that part?
No, that was bad.
I feel
so sorry for him because it's like he's saying no, he's telling the people at the back, guys, please. Please.
But he's so used to speaking in front of people, parliament, addressing political matters.
I feel like it's just the fact that there was a camera, it was a studio, that thing makes you shy. But put like a camera in front of somebody and they'd be out of...
Come on, bro. Just a man, a fish, and then be feeding for a lifetime. That's all he needed to say.
He could have improvised. So, on a much brighter note, this guy tweeted that he wanted an Xbox One. He tweeted at Bonang, he asked Bonang how many retweets does he need to get an Xbox One. And trusted, Bonang came through with the Xbox One X. So the guy tweeted to thank Bonang. He was like, I still can't believe it. At Bonang M, thank you very much. Thank you, may the Lord bless you. Xbox One X delivered today. Thank you very much.
How much
have more life, Queen. I don't know how to thank you enough.
Isn't that like 6, 7K?
Guys,
just like that.
Yeah, just like that.
Shout out, she has a lot of money, but she doesn't even know the guy. Bro.
Shout out to Bonang for that. That was a really
sweet AOB. On that.
Cedric Zaga, how many retweets for a free camera, bro?
Bro, when I had a crush on...
How many retweets, bro?
Everyone knows I used to have a big crush on Tando Tabese. I wanted to ask her, how many retweets do I need to get to take her out on a date?
Weren't you guys conversating in the DM at some point?
We did DM at
once before she was famous. Wasn't this before she was famous?
It was before she... No, I'm joking. She was already pretty famous. I actually met her and she's still an amazing girl. So I think I'm going to do it. Since this guy succeeded and he got a whole 7K worth of gifts, I think I'm going to tweet it out.
I don't think I have luck for such things, bro. Like,
I don't think so either.
The only time I've won any lucky draw was in grade 8 and I wasn't at school, so yeah, actually was something else.
I think...
So yeah. Really messed up.
I'm going to tweet it out. I'm going to be like, ayo, Tando. Tando, how many retweets? I'ma pull through to Joburg. I'ma be in Joburg now in June. So how many retweets?
So what's up for lunch?
Okay.
Stop it.
I don't know. No, I'll put the money together. I don't know. I'll make a plan.
Oh, the light is the best. Can I do the thing?
Yes.
Yeah. Go away. That's what I wanted to do the whole time.
Oh shit.
My mom's watching this. Royal wedding.
Who?
I don't like it either. I thought that I was just trolling.
Well, it's her second wedding, guys, so I don't think. Oh, but
she was married before.
Yes. What do you mean? She's a divorcee, so
the second dress was nice, but everyone else was dressed better than her, but it was her day.
But she's married a prince. She knows.
Yes, with
Oksala. Oksala. You can't win the debate.
What is last? How do you say Oksala in English? Oks, what was last? What's last? What's left?
I don't know.
Most people are complaining about why were none of her dresses fitted. Like, if you're gonna go that simple, it just didn't fit.
They
fit
though.
It didn't fit.
I'm lying, I can see that.
But no, this one's better.
Look, by the way, it's okay. It was cute. It was modern. It was elegant. It was cute. I like
sometimes more is more.
David Beckham. He's so yummy and he's so old and he's still yummy and wow.
I said
no.
He's a dope.
Yes. And we all spoke pretty good. The cast looked good. The whole suit's cast looked amazing.
I did not see them. They were all there.
What wedding were you watching? DJ's in Penny, aka this is my conspiracy. AKA is just being petty. Petty.
Let me tell you why.
Can I please ask what happened? Okay.
On Mother's Day, AKA
posted a picture.
Took Zimba out for lunch with AKA.
Happy Mother's Day.
Okay. Mm-hmm. And then I'm not.
Say Happy Mother's Day.
Say
Happy Mother's Day.
So how's that being petty? This is my conspiracy. If you watch AK Snaps throughout the day and night, he ended up chilling with Nicole. And I think he was just being petty, not to Bonang. I feel like it was just so petty and he was just being spicy and he was saying Bonan, you call it such a main chick, blah blah blah.
Why were you even including Bonan?
I don't even think Bonan.
She doesn't, but I just think like he's being spiteful.
And
I think he's very spiteful, guys.
Why is it spiteful? I think it was finished.
No.
It was thousand.
I feel like, you know, I think he was just trying to market and show his good side.
Well, if
you
marketed it, everybody wins.
And I love the fact that Zinchi just said thank you. And didn't even like dwell upon it. Like, oh,
and then she said thank you.
The next day she posted.
I was like, yes, girl. You should be doing that every day. It shouldn't be only on Mother's Day. Now you're taking me out for lunch. What do you mean?
What if they always go to lunch and just never post about it?
Then it's PR.
Oh, okay.
Then it's PR if it's. So I don't know. But anyway, yeah, don't kill me.
Now we'll understand. Because of the recent tweets, we'll understand why Uma Picha was like in every song. Otherwise,
yes.
Every single song it was featuring Uma Picha. Why?
Like at first, I was like, oh, you know what? He's really paving the way for her in the industry, like, and I was like, on the album drop, I was like, no man, this is a bit too much. Like,
it's never just bait anymore, you know. It was never so. Yeah,
I didn't get the, I didn't listen to it.
No,
I only have two songs.
But shout out to Babes for being strong enough to like speak. Most people don't even get to point where they talk about.
But did you watch the interview? How it came about?
No.
Okay, apparently people are saying that the girl that was interviewing Babes, Master Chab, like put her on the spot and it was, she didn't wanna speak about it. And Master Chab was just like, I know you've been abused. A friend of mine got you, like, you, a friend of mine, you went to a friend of mine's house and you had a broken nose and a broken leg and we took you in, and that's what she did. And then everyone is kind of saying,
so it wasn't actually a choice?
No, it wasn't, like, it was put on the spot. And people are saying,
like, girls are okay, guys.
Yeah. So people are saying it's kind of like PR.
Mm-hmm.
And some people are like, no, it was good that she did it because she was talking for her because she couldn't talk.
But I'm not an issue.
Like, no, but so the end of it goes back to the thing of like, let's say I know you're being abused and I keep crying, the next week you die. And I'm just like, oh, I knew and I didn't. It's that type of
thing. You just need a deep place.
Yeah, but it does happen.
It does.
No.
It does. But like, in the sense that.
No, I feel like they should have done it.
Television.
Yes. Yes. I don't know. What if
asked? She should have asked for permission and should have like spoke about it.
I feel like
it's Loma.
Hey, with
Balam Loma. With the one Teta. Balam Loma.
Okay.
Your
okay, thanks, ladies.
Bye.
No.
Bye.
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 Bye. Bye.
Bye. Bye. Bye.
Bye.
Bye.
Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye.
Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. This lighting deserves me. My God, not the other way around.
Oh my God! Do the tingling again, and then. Jokes, guys. Okay. The most informative part of that was when she was saying.
No.
I didn't use Kanye West.
Lift your socks up on your feet.
And you know what's funny? What? If he actually likes the song.
No.
Don't tell me you like it.
No, I don't like it. I don't like it.
You are all bad.
Scoop with you.
Scoop
with you. Scoop with you. You know what? Just play the song.
Yeah. Okay, there's two perspectives for me. Certain things about music like Gorm and House and whatever, it's just musical instruments and there's no lyrics, so there's no understanding and it makes you feel good and all that. So I understand that part of it being a feel-good song and
it
not being about
but
what he says, what you know, our emotion is involved. I give that.
Honestly,
but
I
come on, bro.
Come on.
Yeah.
Come say hi. And the other girls.
Hey, hey guys.
Just stroll off.
Yeah.
I was just putting up. I'm gonna energy.
I'm so tired. Yeah, so a couple of weeks back, if I'm not mistaken, there was an interview with TMZ that had Kanye West. It was very challenging for me. Essentially, what happened, if you didn't get it, he was having an interview and he was just doing Kanye, babbling and stuff, listening to the kids, bro. And he happened to say something which was rather. I didn't know how to feel about it. He was speaking about.
I was shitty.
how for 300 years people were slaves, and for that long for you to be a slave, 300 years,
he said that shit
at
was
some
a
point
choice.
It has to be a choice.
You know when you have like something that sounds very, very, very sarcastic in your mind, and when you say it, it actually comes out very stupid.
I don't know what that means.
Something that sounds very wise in your mind, but when you say it, it comes out like very sorry. Excuse the verbosity.
I
majoring in communications, I told you.
But what we have to admit though, that mentally is something that's not quite like, there has to be like
did you guys ever stop to think that maybe Kanye is being painted in a bad picture because he's actually trying to tell us something in the media and the people are not trying
painted
to
painted by who, bro? It's coming out of his mouth.
Never mind, everybody flops. Maybe that was a flop, but most of the time everybody just says Kanye's ranting, Kanye's speaking crap.
Okay. Operation.
Let's not turn this into a
just saying.
It's not turning into
a
saying.
Yo, by the way, do you hear Laurel or Yanni?
I hear Yanni.
It's Yanni.
Listen. That thing, it's the same word, but in different pitches.
I know. When you change, when you
at the same time, if you listen, my man, it's something about our brain that anticipates something. So like the fact that they gave you a choice, do you hear Lori and Yanni? You automatically psychologically
but
stop.
But
you choose. You choose without knowing. That's you. You chose without knowing.
For example, did I not make a choice for like one year? Jack Squad.
You, when you saw that thing, in your mind, I have a feeling you were like, I'm not gonna hear from you. This thing is rigged, they're trying to catch us out. So when you listen with that attitude about, I'm gonna catch this shit out. And it was, your outcome was, so all I'm saying is, it's up to you, Bob.
Technically, I had,
that's what you heard, But shout out to Yanny.
The boy TSK just dropped a new video. It's called Vibrations. Man.
And no, not those kind of ones.
Hey, yo, man.
Young's is clean.
Those kind of vibrations.
Yo.
I'm sorry, man.
Microwave Boys, episode X.
Who's a stranger over here? Where did she come from? Where did she come from?
She's a black. For the snack of the week.
Just to set precedent.
Who's the snack of the week?
Basically, this lady came to do the most important thing, especially for you ladies. She's here to link, and not only link, but hook you up with one of the hottest guys in PE, you know. Before this turns gay, I'll keep quiet and just do the things.
Yeah, guys, snack of the week is
Ayasa. We probably have underscore somewhere on the screen. I don't know.
He's beautiful.
Do you like know him on a personal level?
He's the most beautifulest man.
Hey yo, let me talk to my subscribers. Come on, this is me.
Okay.
Let's get these shades on. Guys, thank you so much for watching. Please don't forget to like. Don't forget to subscribe if you haven't. Leave a comment down below. Check out Nothing SA. I'll link their YouTube channel down in the description box. Follow everyone on Instagram. Everyone's Instagram handle is in the description box. Thank you so much for the love, guys. I'll see you after the exam.
Jumping like I got my ankles in the bungee cord. Working like I don't know anybody anymore. All this passion just forces me on the course. So I'm breaking doors and I'm breaking laws. I'm driving up and down the city till I hit the shore. With meditation, just make sure you're rolling with the roll. I swear it feel like it's a mission, but I'm with the boys. Cook another beat, I can't get no sleep. Way too late for the beef, I keep